you decided to install Linux Mint as your second Linux system. So you don't need to install the Linux Mint bootloader, because you already have a bootloader from your primary Linux system. But the problem is, the Linux Mint installer doesn't give you an option to install the system without a bootloader, as you can see here. In this video, I will show you how to overcome this obstacle. Hello everyone, it's Edge Linux User, helping you to install, configure and use Linux. If it's your first time on the channel, consider subscribing. I upload new videos every Wednesday and Friday. If you are not experienced Linux user, it is probably unclear for you why someone would want to install a system without a bootloader. The reason is simple. Bootloader is a piece of code that starts your operating system. If you have several operating systems on your computer, bootloader also allows you to choose which one to boot. Normally, you should not have several bootloaders. So if you already have a Linux system installed, you also have a bootloader. If you decide to install a second Linux system on a separate partition, you can either override the existing bootloader or keep it and install the second system without a bootloader. The rule of thumb is to use that bootloader, which is the latest. There are several bootloaders available for Linux. Group is the most popular one, and I use Group on all my systems. You also most likely have Group bootloader on your system. So in this video, when I talk about a bootloader, I mean Group bootloader. In my situation, I needed to install Linux Mint as my second system to test it, whereas my main system was Arch Linux. So I wanted to keep the bootloader of Arch Linux because it is a rolling distro, so its bootloader will be more up-to-date than Linux Mint's bootloader. Besides, using less updated Linux Mint bootloader could cause booting issues for my bleeding edge Arch Linux system. I followed a normal installation procedure, shrunk the partition of my main system, created a partition for the Linux Mint install, created a bootable USB. If you want to learn how to shrink a partition and create a bootable USB, I have separate videos on these topics. Links are in the description. Then I booted a live USB and followed the instructions. During the partition setup, I selected manual, chose to install Linux Mint on the second partition, and did not touch my main system on the first partition. What a surprise it was when I saw that there was no option to install it without a bootloader, because I remember such option existed in the past. As you can see here, Linux Mint offers to install the bootloader to the SDA hard drive or to some of its partitions, such as SDA1 or SDA2. I think this is a precaution of the Linux Mint team, so new users don't end up with the installation without a bootloader. But if you know what you are doing and you want to install Linux Mint without a bootloader, you need to start the installer from the command line. Linux Mint bootloader is called Ubiquiti. Ubiquiti is a bootloader in Ubuntu and all its derivatives. If you type Ubiquiti with the option help, you can see all possible options. Among these options, the option B is what you need. It will install the system without a bootloader. So type Ubiquiti with option B. And when you get into the partition setup, there is no bootloader option you have seen before. So I installed Linux Mint this way, without a bootloader. Then I updated my Arch Linux group bootloader that it could boot the newly installed Linux Mint. And both Arch Linux and Linux Mint worked fine. I installed KDE Neon without a bootloader the same way. So Ubiquiti with the option B should work on Ubuntu and all its derivatives. I will show how to update group bootloader in Arch Linux to boot the other OSs in my next video. So stay tuned, don't forget to subscribe, and thank you for watching.